So the video you're about to watch is a clip from an interview that I was part of not long ago where Ben and I discussed some of my multi-six-figure affiliate marketing strategies. I hope you get a ton of value out of this. I think that you will. And when you're done watching this clip, if you have any questions, let me know in the comments. And if you want to start high-ticket affiliate marketing like Ben and I, then go ahead and go over to my15daychallenge.com. Start learning how to build a high-ticket affiliate marketing business in 15 days or less. Enjoy the clip.
You mentioned your first big win with affiliate marketing was the Shopify program. And I've made a few TikToks about that because their commission structure is like, it's insane. So I guess what was it about them that, you know, you're like, okay, I'm going to promote this. And is that something you would still recommend to beginners with affiliate marketing?
Yeah. Great couple of questions there. So first and foremost, to take a step back do some context here. 2016 is really when I was like, okay, I'm going to start promoting the Shopify affiliate program. But in 2015, I took one of my product review blogs where I was sending traffic to Amazon and making my 5% commission or whatever it is. And I thought to myself, okay, I have this authority blog that's promoting a niche group of products and I'm only making 5% commission. What if I actually drop ship them and I create my own Shopify store? And instead of sending my blog traffic to Amazon, what if I send my blog traffic to my store? Then I can make 40% on each sale, right? So that was the initial idea. And that was, once again, 2015. Just to kind of talk about that, the first thing that happened is conversions went way down because I no longer had the trust associated with Amazon. So I was pretty much net zero at that point anyways. Like a 5% conversion, a 5% commission at a 15% conversion is a lot better, or about the same as a 40% commission at a 2% conversion, if that makes sense. But anyways, the point was, then I had the fulfillment issues. Then I had, you know, lost shipments and customer service. I was like, whoa, crap, I don't want to do this at all. So I sold my blogs, as I mentioned, and one guy who bought them happened to be a drop shipper in the same niche or whatever, and great for him. But at that point, now here I am in 2016, like, okay, I tried the blogging thing. It didn't work out. I have experience with drop shipping and Shopify. It's like, okay, cool. This is obviously going to be a thing, right? There were a couple people who were big in the space. You know, this, you know, if you follow affiliate marketing, you probably know Franklin Hatchett and stuff like that. He was big into drop shipping back then. I was like, okay, cool. This maybe is an opportunity here. So what I did is I thought, cool, I have some knowledge. I have a product that I've used. And that's important, I think, in all affiliate marketing. If you don't know the product that you're promoting, you're going to suffer. You're going to struggle. So the best thing to do is learn the product that you're going to promote first. Learn, do, and then teach. So that's what I did. I took my experience with Shopify. I created a free course. It was about a 2-hour tutorial that showed people how to get a Shopify store set up, how to populate it with products at that time from AliExpress, and then how to run your first Facebook ad. And what I did is I just gave that away for free. I made a free course. Obviously, it had affiliate links for Shopify and for other Facebook advertising courses that earned me a commission and different software that helped people identify good products. And I gave it away and I created content on YouTube that essentially gave it away in bits and pieces. So if this course is 2 hours, then I would do a 10-minute video on this particular topic and say, hey, if you want to learn more, go check out my free course. Well, as a result, it was a lot of good timing, but, my YouTube videos went viral. I generated like 60,000 leads in that first year for free. I've made over, just for fun, like $200,000+ in front end Shopify commissions alone. It was like, wow, this is great. You know what I mean? So that was kind of the aha moment, like, okay, give first. And this affiliate marketing thing can really become kind of a passive income stream if you create content. So to kind of answer your question, it was because I had experience with it, but it was also an opportunity. I don't think you should ever promote something that there's no demand for. And then for me, the dropshipping game became what it became. And I think we all know what it has become. And, for example, one of my YouTube channels, I had videos that were ranking and I simply pulled them because I didn't want to be associated with the drop shipping scene as it had become. Right. And it's up to everybody. If you have familiarity with Shopify and you want to be in that scene and you want to do it ethically, I think it's still okay to promote, but if you're just getting started, I wouldn't necessarily go to Shopify as a good affiliate program. Because it's a lot harder to get approved now that they're a big company, right? They only want the top tier affiliates. And B, dropshipping isn't the low-hanging fruit it once was in 2015, 2016, and 2017. Back then, it made sense to get into dropshipping in my mind. Now, it's just a really hard business, right? You know what I mean? So why not do affiliate marketing instead? So that's kind of my whole Shopify backstory and view on that now.
No, that makes sense. I don't get why people do, like, people who are starting their businesses right now, I don't know honestly why somebody would really want to choose dropshipping, because if you're comparing affiliate marketing and dropshipping, they're equal until like a certain point. And then dropshipping, all the work just keeps piling up or continuing, I should say. And it's like, oh, it seems like such a headache. So yeah, I'm with you. I'm just steer clear of dropshipping. You know, there may be some people saying though, like, okay, I get it. You created a course. I get it. You posted content every day. But there's what would you say to the people that are like, but you know, I don't have any followers. I don't know how to create a course. You know, I don't know anything about getting a website ranked. You know, what advice do you have for them to get started?
Yeah, I mean, so first of all, nobody knows anything when they get started. You know, in 2016, I had been in this affiliate marketing scene for a couple of years now, and I still wasn't where I wanted to be. So I decided it was time to put myself out there. And I swear to goodness, the first video I ever created, the first piece of real live content that was my face I ever created, I mean, I looked like a hostage. I was standing there and I didn't know what to do. There was a fireplace in the house I was living at the time. I thought, hey, that's a cool brick. That can be my background. And I put a lamp in front of me and I turned my cell phone on. It was like, here we go. And you just go out there and do it. And yeah, it sucks. Yeah, it's hard. But using your voice, your face, your authentic self, that's your number one competitive advantage. So you may as well use it. And the opportunity is too huge to pass up. Like, I thought to myself, like, I'm not going to sit here and let fear prevent me from making, at the time, I thought like $100,000 a year. You know what I mean? And obviously the potential is much greater than that. I was like, I'm not going to be afraid. I'm not going to feel stupid and then miss out on this huge opportunity. But kind of to piggyback on what I was saying there is when you put yourself out there, when you put your face out there, that's actually the easy way. What people don't realize, like, so running Facebook ads really hard, because you got to test and tweak and the prices fluctuate, you got competition, and there's, you know, people don't trust ads inherently. Or, you know, creating a blog anonymously, right? Like, it's so hard to get ranked number one, two, or three in Google, and that's the only way you're ever going to make money. Those seem easy, but they're actually the hard way. You put your face out there, the algorithms are designed to bring people who will like you for you. So it's like me and you, Ben, if we were sitting in front of a kindergarten class, right? There's 20 kids in the kindergarten class, and here we're there that day as guest teachers. We're going to help them learn how to tie their shoes. I'm assuming you know how to tie your shoes, right?
I do know how to tie my shoes.
Yeah. Yes. Okay, cool. Yeah. I know how to tie my shoes as well. We probably both tie our shoes the same way. And if we don't, we probably get the same result. We probably both end up with tied shoes. Well, if we sat in front of that kindergarten class and started teaching people how to tie shoes, half the kids would kind of get out of their seats and come watch you, and the other half of the kids would get out of their seats and come watch me. It's not because you're better at tying your shoes than me, or vice versa. It's just because people are naturally kind of gravitate towards people for whatever reason. And I'm sure there's some science behind it, but we don't have to think about that. If we just go out there and be our authentic self, then the algorithms, the YouTubes, the TikToks, the whatever else, they're going to find people who like us for us. And it's like the easy button. It's the cheat code. It's the hack. So just go out there and do it. And don't worry about the tech. You're not in the business of creating the best website. You're in the leadership business. Learn, do, teach. Learn some things and then teach it to people to help them better their lives. And guess what? They'll purchase whatever it is that you're recommending at that point.
So I hope that cleared everything up. If you have any additional questions, leave them in the comments. I'll get to them as soon as possible. Make sure you check out the description for links to my private Facebook group. And if you want to get started learning high-ticket affiliate marketing as fast as possible, go over to my15daychallenge.com. We'll see you soon.